Asset management is an extension to cockpit and inspector that bridges the gap between traditional data capture, flight by flight, and asset management. It simplifies your data processing workflows by merging data from subsequent flights on a single digital twin of your asset. It lets you see all the previous flight trajectories and points of interest while flying. On the Inspector 5 side, the screen display changed, but most of the features are still available. Helios 2 data are not compatible with Inspector 5, and Datamap will not be compatible either. The main difference is how the data are organized. Once installed, you will land on the home page of Inspector 5. You will need to import the data from Inspector 4 if you want them in Inspector 5. Inspector 4 will still be available in the future. You can find your asset, import, export, settings, updates, and help menus on the left side of your screen. In the middle of the page, you can find your different workspaces with the different assets and information on how many flights have been done, the total size of the folder, and which drone was used. A workspace can have multiple assets in it with multiple inspections and flights. It is a new way to organize data and be able to share them easily. If you have multiple workspaces, you can select them directly on the drop-down menu. Then, you can click on Show Inspection and then open the inspection. The video will start playing automatically, but you can always pause it by using the space bar or clicking on the pause button. On the lower part of the screen, you can see the timeline of the flight. If you have multiple flights in the inspection, you can find the different timelines there. The green lines are the point of interest. To add new POI, simply click on the POI icon on the top of your screen. This will open the point of interest menu. On the top of your screen, you can find options like the digital zoom, the thermal camera, the RGB contrast and brightness control, the copy or same frame button, the undistortion button, the place mark, the line, and the two-dimension measurement. Then on the right side, if you click on the plus sign, you will add a view of the 3D map in your report. You can add multiple views and orientations to each point of interest. You can then delete them by clicking on the small trash icon next to it. Click on the pen icon to open the annotation menu. In this panel, you can change the name of the point of interest, add custom tags with colors, and add a criticality level and a description. Once finished, just click on Save and Close. The color of your POI will change with its level of criticality. On the right side panels of this list, you can find 5 icons. The first one is just information about your flight. The second one shows your folder hierarchy. In this menu, you can hide or show the trajectory, map, or snapshots of your flights. The next icons are the annotation settings. Then you have the report settings. You can select which information you want to import in your report and select your logo. Then you can simply click on Generate a PDF to create your report. The last icon allows you to export your data in different ways, from exporting your point cloud, the snapshots, or exporting frames from Pix4D. The last option is to export Faro Connect, BAG and JSON. Another important new setting is the possibility to manually align flights. This might prove useful if you do some flights without doing the relocalization at the start, or simply if you have a different takeoff place. On the left side of your screen, you can select the import menu. From this page, you can import data directly from an Helios 3. Or you can import data from another workspace. Select the folder data to import from and then select the asset to import. And finally, you can import data from Inspector 4. You need to select the folders that contain FLY files. Then you select or create a new asset and inspection and click on import. You will then be able to open your data imported in Inspector 5. The next menu on the left side will be the export menu. This is the best way to export workspaces to other drives. This will copy the full folder hierarchy and make sure next time you load the workspace, everything comes back the same way. there is nothing new on the settings or help menu.